Strictly Politics. We're talking about the Marcos burial. Joining us now by telephone is Congressman Elpidio Barzaga. He signed a resolution authored by Representative Salvador Escudero that supports a burial of Marcos in the Libingan. I hope I got that right. And of course, Attorney Senator Rene Saguisag is still with us. Congressman Barzaga, good evening.
Good evening, Pia.
Sir, tell us why, first of all, you signed that resolution.
Yes, I was one of those who signed the resolution requesting for the burial of the former President Marcos at the Libingan ng mga Bayani.
Mm-hmm. And you did that because what is your personal stand on that?
Well, number one, to begin with, during martial law, I am one of the active members of the Parliament of the State. As a matter of fact, when there was the revolution, I was appointed as OIC. With that, excuse me, I think we have to put a closure on this issue.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, we have to decide whether or not to bury him at the Libingan ng mga Bayani. As a former president of the Republic of the Philippines, pursuant to existing laws, he is entitled to be buried at the Libingan ng mga Bayani.
Mm-hmm.
And although there has been attributes that he was a dictator, nonetheless, President Marcos has never been right during his lifetime, and there has been no conviction in so far as he is concerned.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, from the legal point of view, I see no reason why he should not be buried there, although he was toppled on account of a people's revolution.
Mm-hmm. So as far as you're concerned, burial in Libingan and military honors?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Because Senator Saguisag, who's here, also representing a majority, if not almost all the members of Mabini, is saying that they do not like the idea, and I'm saying that that's an understatement, no? The idea of burying him, even in Ilocos Norte, with military honors, dapat daw walang military honors because it's a repudiation of the verdict of 1986 and the verdict of the High Court 2003.
Yes, but that is their position. At ang position naman namin, ng karamihan ng mga congressman, pagkakataon na ito, natapusin natin itong problemang ito, and being a former president, and considering that there was no conviction on his part, it's about time na isettle natin ang issue. At the same time, mm-hmm. we have to amend or to mend these forces which are pro-EDSA and against in favor of Marcos in order to start for the country. And as long as this issue is lingering, we cannot make that start.
Mm. So you're talking about
the pro and anti-Marcos forces.
Oh, so ang pinag-usapan po dito, sir, as far as you're concerned, is parang national reconciliation. Is that what you're saying? So you're saying that there will be...
Definitely. Alam mo naman tayo mga Pilipino, kahit na anong pagkakasala natin, nagpapatawad tayo, most especially in this particular case, that it's more than 20 years.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The former president has already died.
Yeah.
Naniniwala man tayo, we have to put yung kanyang soul o yung kanyang ay kailangan mamahinga na.
Mm-hmm.
And perhaps it's about time that we have to decide this issue after all this lapse of more than 20 years
uh-huh.
from the time of his death.
Okay. And as far as you're concerned, this is an issue of closure na... Para bang let's, kanina nga ang sabi ko eh, parang ang gusto niyo eh, let's get it over with. Parang ganun lang? Ganun na yun?
Well, actually, 20 taon na ang nakakaraan eh. As a matter of fact, lahat na naman ng legal na paraan, ginawa na natin. And so far as the Marcos issue is concerned, recovery of his wealth, attempting to put in bars, his cronies, and all these things are already water under the bridge. E bakit hindi pa natin tapusin yung issue tungkol sa paglilibing kay Presidente Marcos?
Yeah. Well, Senator Saguisag also has an issue with the resolution. Why a resolution? And he's saying that mas mainam ata kung batas. Bakit hindi bill na lang? No? Meaning
hindi?
It will... Batas. Why not file a proposed bill that will lead to debates, a whole debate in Congress, in both houses of Congress, and so that there will be voting by the members of both houses.
We're waiting for the decision of the president insofar as this issue is concerned. And the event that there will be the final determination, I think, legislators would be moving for the enactment of a law, as suggested by you, in order to find closure for this issue.
But at the same time, Vice President Binay's position is burial in Ilocos. Ang gusto ninyo ng mga pumirma sa resolution na ito is burial in Libingan. So this runs counter also to what Jojo Binay is thinking of.
Yes, that is entirely different from the resolution signed by a number of congressmen, I think majority of us.
Mm-hmm. And you don't agree that he should be buried in Ilocos?
Well, that is an alternative. Pero so far as kaming mga pumirma riyan, ang aming preference is for the former president to be buried at the Libingan ng mga bayani, he being a former president.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, Senator, like I said, Senator Saguisag is still here, and I wanted to give him an opportunity to speak to you, Congressman Barzaga, and to react also to what you've been saying. Senator Saguisag.
Congressman Fede, good evening.
Yes, good evening.
Yeah, ang position lang namin dito, number one, in fairness to Bongbong, sayata can live with the suggestion of Jojo Binay. Kaya siguro, at least that is a step forward. Pero dun sa military honors, nahihirapan din kami doon dahil that will overturn or nullify People Power 1986. And all the decisions in Seattle, in Honolulu, and even our own Supreme Court ruled on July 15, 2003, na si Jane Ryan at si William Saunders, Makoy and Imelda, mga mandrambong. Kaya hindi napakadali nitong isyong ito. Kaya dapat siguro nga gawin panukalang batas para magkaroon ng public hearings, magkaroon ng debates, magkaroon ng recorded voting para recorded in all history kung ano ang paninindigan ng bawat kasapi ng Kongreso. I assume na, I am sure na binasa mong mabuti yan dahil tayo sa San Beda PD talagang kailangang nag-aaral eh. But I am not so sure na yung 290 na yun don't validate yung sinabi ni Monching na kahit anong panukala pipirmahan ng congressman kahit toilet paper. Kaya dito, medyo maglimi-limi tayo. Gawin nating panukalang batas. Magkaroon ng full public hearings, full plenary discussions, and recorded voting. Yan okay. Ang alternatibo namin sa Mabini.
Well, una-una, natutuwa kami at napag-usapan natin to. Pangalawa, nais lamang naming i-emphasize that this is a resolution. And when we speak of resolution, it merely expresses the sentiment of the members of the House regarding this issue of burial. And therefore, since it is a resolution, hindi naman kami nagkaroon ng pagtatago rito, hindi kami nagkaroon ng hearing. And therefore, in the event that there would be a bill pertaining to this issue, definitely there will be a public hearing, definitely we have to consider the sentiments of everybody, including the possible repercussions, legal repercussions pertaining to the cases filed.
Eh, pero ang dating sa amin yan, eh, it's a resolution to nullify the people's verdict of February 25, 1986. Yun ang lumalabas dun eh, na kayo, Mabini, kayo, Fidi, lahat ng nandigan sa EDSA, kayo, mali. Hindi nyo dapat pinatalsik ang bayani. Kaya dapat yan pag-usapan kung talagang we are ready to reverse the popular verdict of 1986 that made us a darlings of the entire world. Kaya dito, there is the risk na baka pagtawanan tayo ng buong mundo eh. We're a wishy-washy people. Yung villain nung 25 years ago, hero 25 years later. Hindi madaling paliwanag sa mundo, hindi madaling ipaliwanag sa mga apo natin, eh bakit tayo nanindigan sa EDSA? Eh hero pala yung nilabanan natin. Kaya ito eh, medyo relak-relak tayo, pag-usapan.
Well, we are amenable to that proposal.